$100, what does it mean to you? What is it worth to you? And the bigger question is, what could it be worth to you? That's what we're talking about in today's video as we look at compounding interest examples using $100. It's coming up right now. Hey guys, welcome back to Money and Life TV. As you guys know, my name is Mike, the CPA, and you all know my sidekick, Chipper the Cockatiel.
I'm here.
How's your day going? It is so good, once again, to see all of your smiling faces. I hope no matter where you're at or what you're doing, that you're having a great day. I just really want to say thank you to all of you guys who have been watching my videos and supporting this channel. It means so much to me to be able to make these videos and interact with you guys over YouTube. So all of you guys make this experience special, so thank you so much. You guys are just an awesome audience and community, and this channel seems to be growing much faster than I ever expected. Okay guys, I think we're gonna have some fun with this topic. At least, I know I am. So we're talking about $100 today, and I have a special treat for all of you. In the description section below this video, I've included a free downloadable spreadsheet that is an annual compounding interest Excel spreadsheet that you can download completely free. I made it myself, but feel free to use it and download it after you've watched this video. You guys know how much I love to design and give away spreadsheets on this channel. I mean, I have a mug that says, "I love spreadsheets." Before I dive into that spreadsheet, I just want to take a moment to talk to you guys about what $100 means to me and how my decision-making around the money has changed my life and in the way I save money and the way I invest money. I remember growing up, now I was born in 85. And so I really grew up in the 90s. And I just remember, and I don't know if you guys can like think back to when you were growing up of what $100 meant to you, but I just remember like being really into video games at that point in my life. I was always into electronics and things like that. And so when I saw 100, like I'm like, man, to me, that meant like new games. And you know, I grew up in the era when, you know, like the N64 was really popular. And so I had, you know, was buying games with that money, like, you know, the original Mario N64 and GoldenEye, and even in Super Nintendo, just being able to buy those new games, because even back then, the games were expensive. I think Final Fantasy III at the time in America, which is like Final Fantasy VI, I think it was like $100. But just that $100 meant a lot to me back then because of what it represented and what it could buy. But now, in what I wanted to talk to you guys though, as I matured, as I still play some games, but as I wanted to learn more about finances and more about investing and things like that, I really started to think about money differently. And it was in high school, I took an economics course, because as you guys know, you probably had to take one too in high school, and you're like, what the heck is this? And then like years later, it starts to make sense. But when you're in high school, you're like, I don't get this whole economics thing. Why do I have to learn this? Well, in economics, there's a term that is known as opportunity cost. So the opportunity cost is basically based on decisions we make. We have a scarce amount of resources or a certain amount of resources at our disposal. And the decisions we make with those resources can make or break us. It can really alter the course of our lives. Every decision we make with money can alter the course of our lives. And so I thought $100 was kind of a fun example because it's just an easy amount to think about. Part of the way I think about my wife and I's finances is in $100 increments. If I'm looking at my budget, and I have a very detailed budget, and I have spreadsheets for that too, which I'll link in the description section below. But I really think about like, okay, what can I do differently? What can I do to either make $100 more a month or save $100 more a month? Because it really adds up. And I found that until I saw what $100 could add up to on, you know, when you compounding interest is applied to it, I really didn't value it that much. So that's what I want you to be thinking about as we go over this spreadsheet right now, is think about every $100 more you can save, every $100 more you can make an income, how much quicker that can grow your wealth and help your family and help you achieve your financial goals in your life. So I hope you guys will join me now on screen, and we're gonna look at this compounding interest spreadsheet I made for you guys. It's very simple, it's very basic, and it'll just take a second, and I'll show you the power of what $100 could be worth to you for every $100 you're able to make more or save more every single month. Let's check it out right now. Okay guys, this will only just take a second to show you, but so what we're looking at on screen is an annual compounding interest spreadsheet. And we're gonna look at an example using $100 like we were just talking about earlier. Now, what you're gonna notice is there, you're gonna put $100 in, or we're gonna put $100 into this calculation, and we're gonna add no more beyond that. And we're gonna see what our $100 can grow into over a period of time based on various rates. So in order to get this to work, what we do is we come over here, and the only input that you really need to do in this spreadsheet is just drop in the dollar amount you want to compound right here, and it's gonna compound annually for you. So literally, that's all you have to do. If you wanna tweak the interest rate, you can change these interest rates, feel free to, it's not gonna hurt anything, but then the spreadsheet is gonna do the rest of the work for you. And you don't have to worry about entering the number of years you want it to compound. I've done all that for you over here in the left-hand column. So it starts right here, and then it covers 40 years of compounding interest. Okay, if you want me to add another 10 years for 50, or if you want to do it, feel free to do so. But all we do is we're going to come here, we're going to drop in $100, and watch how the magic works of this spreadsheet. Boom. So now what we can do is we can start with, if we had $100 that we invested and it compounded at 1%, and we wanted to know what that would compound to over 20 years at 1% annually, we would just come down here, go to 20 years, which is right here. So if we have $100 compounding at 1% in 20 years, it's gonna be worth $122.02. Now what about 8% or six, you know, yeah. So now what about 8%, which is the long-term stock market average? So if we invested in stocks at $100 and then we never looked back and we got 8% per year for 40 years, what we would do is we come to this column right here, scroll all the way down, line up your finger on the very last row here, 40 years, that money, let me make sure, yep, that money at 8%, $100, would grow to $2,172 after 40 years compounding at 8%. So if you think about it, that mathematically, that money is now, we take the $2,172, divide it by 100. So for every $100 that we're able to save and we let it compound for a long period of time at 8% interest, the money is 21 times more than what we initially started with. Damn! And so that's kind of how I love compounding interest, and I love seeing examples like this, because visually we can start to see a different value of what our money, whether it's $100 or any other figure, can become when we think about compounding interest and opportunity cost. If we go blow this money, it never can become that. And not that we're gonna stop all spending because we can't, but if we can think about how we can make more of these or save more of these and what it can compound to over time, it could completely change our life. Now you're probably saying, Mike, how do we know that your spreadsheet's correct? How do I know that your calculations are accurate? Well, that's a great question, and you should definitely be asking that, because I asked the same question after I made it. I'm like, is this right? I needed something to test it against. Well, one of my favorite online calculators is TVM Calculator App. It has a bunch of financial calculators in it, and I actually have this on my phone, but we're on the website right now, and I'll link this up too. It's got so many different free calculators you can use, and it's just wonderful. I love this place. And so right now we're on the compounding interest calculator. So Chipper, give me an example to test with the audience.
I'm all over it.
So Chipper wants to see an example of $250 compounded annually at 8% for 20 years. Okay, so let's see what this calculator gets, and then let's test it against the spreadsheet I made for you guys. So we're gonna put in $250 here. And we, like I said, it's annual compounding, so we're gonna change this compounding to annual.
put that in right there. And we know that there's no further deposits, that's zero. In 20 years, so we know that 20 times 12 is 240. So that's 240 compounding periods. And it compounds annually, of course. But interest rate's 8%. And in this calculator gets, that turns into $1,165.24 after 20 years at 8%, $250 at that rate. Now let's test my spreadsheet that I've made against that. So I'm gonna put in $250 here. Boom, $250, 8%, 20 years. Look at that, guys. It is spot on. $1,165.24. Open the calculator. $1,165.24. So you guys can see that's how the spreadsheet works. So like I said, you can just change interest rates if you want to calculate different interest rates. You can change the investment amount to whatever you want it to be. You can make it, like if you put in like 50,000, sometimes it's fun to see, what if I invested 50,000 and never looked back? Well, then you can see how 50,000 would compound to over time, and it can grow pretty easily to over $1 million. So this is just a tool that you guys can use, and that's all I have for you for the spreadsheet. I hope you guys find that helpful.
All right, guys, I really hope you found that spreadsheet helpful. Feel free to download it for yourself. If you have any problems at all downloading it, just let me know. I'll be happy to either update the link, or I can send it to you over Google Docs or another format so that you can access it. Now, the idea of the spreadsheet that I have designed for you guys is really, you know, when I look at things visually on paper, when I can see what something can become, it really alters my decision and helps me make better decisions. And that's really the point of the spreadsheet is to motivate you, to help you think differently of how you can save $100 more a month, or how you can make, you know, $100 more a month, and just what that amount of money can grow to, whether it's $100, $1,000, or $10,000, of what it could potentially do for you in your situation. That's what I hope you guys take away from this video. If you guys have any questions about the spreadsheet at all, just let me know. But I would love to hear from you guys of what does $100 mean to you, especially as when you're younger. What did that $100 represent? What was the one thing when you got that $100 bill, just for fun, what would you want to go out and buy? That's what I'd love to know. And it'd be fun to hear guys' responses in the comment section down below. All right, guys, thank you as always for hanging out with me here again over YouTube. It is always a blast seeing you guys. Now, if you like the video, make sure you drop a like to help support this video and this channel. Share this information with a friend, especially a friend who's interested in saving more money or who's interested in becoming more savvy with their finances. I'm sure they'll find this information helpful. And of course, be sure to subscribe if you have not already, because every single week, as you guys know, I create new videos to help you with your finances, your investments, taxes, and so much more. So please consider subscribing if you have not already. It was great seeing you guys. I hope you have a great week, and I will see you in the next video. Love you guys. Peace.